Hey guys, I am Trish with Unique Me 303 Healing and Empowerment. This message is going to be for the week ahead. I'm sorry I didn't get it out to you guys last night. I had my children over, my grandson over. We had a Harry Potter marathon that started on Saturday and still didn't get to finish the last two movies on Sunday, but they were here until about 8 o'clock yesterday night. And so, am I supposed to take all of these? So, I just didn't get to do it. I wanted to spend time with my family. I apologize for the lighting. It's kind of wee-whacked or whatever. That's a word that my mom always said, and I say it all the time now. So if you don't know what that means, it just means it's out of sort or not exactly the way that we want it to be or what have you. But anyhow, so I wanted to do this reading for the week ahead, see what kind of energies are coming in. I just wanted to remind you guys real quick, 5-5, that there is some really intense energies that are coming from the solar system. So some of you guys may be feeling some extreme pain across your shoulders. I've been going through that. Maybe even headaches or tension behind the eyes even. May even have interrupted sleep at this time. However, just push through those things. It's much needed. So just power through it the best way that you know how. Anyhow, let's go ahead and get started. I will do some popsicle sticks. Hopefully I don't forget. I am feeling a little all over the place. I'm usually at work at this time, but there's some things that are going on, some things in private that, you know, I needed to take care of or what have you. And so that's that. But let's go ahead and see what kind of messages that we have for today. And then if there's any healing that comes out from the popsicle sticks, we'll do that as well at the end. So which cards will I start with, please? Never expect to start out with these. I always use these for like love and romance confirmation cards, but they come out every once in a while. So let's see what kind of messages they have for us at this time. This is driving me nuts seeing that. Okay. You guys are seeing all these spots on my face. It's from some stomach acid for a couple days last week. My stomach is really messed up from some stress or what have you. And I woke up one morning with a bunch of blisters on my mouth. So it is what it is. Can't not do my videos because of them. So let's see what kind of messages that we have coming out for us this week. In love, romance, finance, ascension messages. Messages from spirit. Am I supposed to take that? Forgiveness is at the forefront. So this may be forgiveness for yourself, forgiveness for others. Some of you are taking a dive deep into waters from the past. And what I'm seeing is literally some of you are just wanting to clear some energies because you've been so positive, so happy. You know that you're moving forward and you're wanting to keep that forward movement. And there's some energies of some things that just keep coming to the surface, or maybe you're just feeling as if, you know, you need to take care of it to clear it out. Some of you may be newly awakened beings who are also seeing that you need to clear some things out that have to do with forgiveness. This is the time for some sort of new adventure for some of you. This may be an adventure in a romantic relationship, maybe even in a new career. Someone is writing a book and maybe and even in need of finally getting this book edited or shared, copied, whatever it is that is the process for writing a book. I'm talking to somebody about that. And then some of you are being asked to back away from a certain situation, place, person, thing, an energy that may be holding you back. 3, 4, 5. I was told to tell you guys, look that up on Sacred Scribes as well. So this is an energy saying, no, it's not the time for a new adventure. So for some of you, you are going to be needing to use your gift of discernment, because there may be more than one situation that this is referring to for just one person. But then for others of you, it may just be that it's saying, yes, move in this direction towards your adventure. And for others of you, they're like, this is a definite no. It is not time. There's certain people, certain energies that are just no longer resonating with you. And you need to try to decipher through your discernment of spirit, which is it that it's telling you. Some of you may have more than one situation that's being answered. So you're going to have to use your discernment with both of those. I was told to tell you guys 414 for whatever reason. Let me see what else is coming out. Which cards do I go to now? They're telling me to go back to these cards. So let's see what else they have for us. What other messages do you have, please? In love, romance, finance, ascension messages. Messages from spirit or higher self, please. In love, romance. Thank you. Both of them? All three of them. Okay. So the very next card is, it's not the right time. Okay. So for some of you that got this answer of no, and that was your confirmation that you needed. Spirit is saying it's just not the right time. Maybe the timing, maybe later, but right now it is not the right time for this new adventure, for this new relationship, for this new whatever. However, Spirit is reminding me to go back to, if you're one of those people who thought you should have been moving forward in a relationship, a career, what have you, then this was your answer. Don't try to make this no fit because your ego, your fears, your doubts take you to making this answer fit. Because for some of you, it's a definite yes, okay? It is the time. I hate when messages come out like that. It doesn't happen very often, but you know, this is the time to use that gift of discernment. For some of you, there's going to be something much better than what you was expecting with this situation. So for the no situation, that it's not the right timing. Timing is just off. There is going to be something better that comes your direction. For some of you, this is Spirit's way of just removing whatever this is to bring to you this yes answer. Okay. So it could be a person, a job, a, you know, anything and everything. I'm going to put those together and then compromise. So for some of you that have this yes answer, yes, move in this direction of that career, or yes, move in this direction of new love and romance, or making something to a committed state, Spirit is saying there's going to be some things that you need to talk out, that you need to work through with this person, this business, this whatever that is involved, this other energy that is involved. Maybe it's for more money. Maybe it's because you just can't figure out how to take it from this step to the next step in a relationship. And Spirit's saying everything's going to be provided along the way. There is going to be balance. I'm seeing balance with both of these energies. So there is going to be balance. It's about making those decisions to move forward and being confident for some, whatever reason, being confident. And some of you, maybe this forgiveness energy is that you need to forgive something from your past so that this yes answer feels that much better to walk into, okay? It's an energy that you just are confident and you just know because you've forgiven something from the past. Maybe it's a person, maybe it's something that you've done or didn't do, or somebody did or didn't do, or, you know, whatever it may be, it's time to let go of those energies, cut the cords with it. 717, I was told to tell you guys, in 711. But cut the cords with it and see whatever it is that needs to be forgiven and let go. Let go, let go. Which cords do I go to now? Thank you. What other messages do you have, please, for the week ahead in love? So some of you, I don't even like saying this, but for somebody has been feeling like there's going to be some sort of disaster or a tower moment, or maybe you've just got this, like, I don't know, somebody that is watching this right now has some sort of deep intuitive feeling or deep knowing that something is just getting ready to happen. And I feel like this is Spirit's way of saying, okay, we're trying to show you, like, you have this gift of seeing things ahead of time. So when you see these things ahead of time, sometimes you can keep them from happening by putting some sort of action into telling somebody something, or maybe shifting timelines to go this direction instead of this direction. Or maybe you just need to give somebody some information that is going to help them to change their mindset and not move in the direction that is going to cause this bad luck or this ill time or whatever it may be. So some of you are learning about those knowings that you have, those clairvoyant visions, maybe just these intuitive insights that you're getting into situations with others, but maybe it even is for yourself. There is a number 8 on that card, which is about abundance, going with the flow, being in the flow. There is also the number 4-4 on it, which is also adds up to an 8. So 8-8 and 4-4 may be a number that you guys need to look up as well. Some of you are in an energy of being a positive role model for someone else. For some of you, this is, you're looking up to somebody, somebody that this yes answer is to. And I'm speaking to somebody that was thinking about they needed to forgive a situation from the past so they can move into a new commitment with somebody else or something like that. So this is a new partnership, romantic partnership. For one of you, or maybe both of you, you're role models to the other person in this situation. You're somebody that they look up to. They even feel maybe a little inferior to, or something of that sort. But I do feel like even whatever this is that needs to be forgiven, for a lot of you, this is going to be somebody from your past that you're wanting to work something out with. It could have been from years ago. It could have been, you know, from several weeks ago. I don't know, but it's going to be different for everybody. But there's something about being that positive role model or them being a role model for you, helping you to see what you need to heal. Maybe you guys are even mirroring situations, or as soon as I said mirroring, 10:01 showed up on the clock. So look that up as well. That is a number of endings and conclusions, as well as new beginnings and new cycles. But somebody or both of you are mirroring some sort of energy off of each other that is helping you to heal what needs to be healed so that you can move forward without disagreeable energies, a lot of arguments, a lot of challenges. I'm not saying that there won't be any challenges or arguments or disagreeable times. What I'm saying is you'll be able to push through them and push through them with confidence that you'll be able to get to the other side. Confidence that it's not going to be like it was in the past. Okay. Remember, you've forgiven these energies, so you can't bring them over into the new start. Okay. You want to leave them behind as best as possible. I'm not saying that you will never be triggered for those past energies to come up, but for a lot of you, you know, you'll be able to walk into this new situation feeling more freedom, more in control, maybe even more like you can just relax. Something is shifting for some of you that is making you feel a little bit more joyful about a situation, this situation, okay? And maybe even feeling a little bit better about letting go of this situation so that you can move into this situation. For some of you, that's exactly what you've had to do. So I don't know why I feel like it's significant, but double jacks. So some of you may know something about jacks, or, you know, the Joker maybe even, but there's two J's here that may even be significant of somebody's initials or something like that. But the book is about information, maybe even mysteries being revealed. Maybe there's some insight that some information that you was getting insight into that you didn't have clarity on. And this book is just showing you that clarity is coming, or maybe that you've already had the clear vision about it, that there's nothing more that you need to read into it. I feel like a lot of you have decisions to make when it comes to, you know, this energy that is a no, and this energy that is a yes. And some of you, this information or this decision can only be made once you receive a little bit more information, a little bit more clarity, and spirit says that's already there. So some of you have been waiting for no reason. You know, you have all, maybe, let's just say this is a relationship. Okay. You've let go of something that you felt really happy about. It made you feel hopeful, but there was just some aspect of it you had to let go of. And then you move into this energy of yes, but you still have to forgive either this person because of something from the past, or the situation, or maybe this thing that you walked away of that was a no. You have to let go of something like that. But spirit says the information that's already there is like, we're showing you that this is better than what you had before. It may be because maybe there's a spiritual aspect that wasn't there before. Maybe there's some sort of giving of nurturing energy that wasn't there in a different relationship. Okay. Like there's something that just wasn't there, and you just know that, you know, that, you know, that this is going to be better for you. So spirit has been showing you all along through some sort of information that they're giving you, or ways that this person may be acting towards you, and showing you like, hey, it's already there. We're giving it to you. You just got to let go of and forgive something that may be holding you back from your past. Okay. This is the past. And then once you do that, you're going to have a newfound love of life. This is a card of having community, unity, coming together, friendships, loyalty, partnerships, but a love of life, a love of fellowship, a love of coming together, happiness. I feel happiness. However, there may be a little bit of disagreeable energies in the beginning. There always is in relationships, but even if this is like in a career path, or, you know, saying no to this old career and moving into this yes of a new adventure, there's always going to be some challenges. So spirit is saying, you know, even though there's going to be challenges, you're going to get through them. You're going to have the information to navigate you through and to 1414, guys, look that up as well, to this place of where you're going to have this newfound love of life, a feeling of unity, a feeling of everything's coming together, or everything is already together. Okay. I was told to read the bottom, which is a letter. The letter is about information. This could be that somebody is going to tell you something that you've been wanting to hear. Maybe you've been waiting for some information to be given to you, and Spirit saying that is now on its way. Expect this within the next couple hours, next couple days, maybe even next couple months. But I do feel like it's very soon. Okay, but there's some sort of information. I do feel like this information is coming from a person. It may be a masculine energy. However, it doesn't have to be. But I do feel like there is some unexpected good fortune, unexpected information that's going to be given, and random events that could happen that's going to make help to steer you in the direction of saying, going with the yes instead of the no. Okay. Some of you maybe are even in need of ending soul contracts. I have been thinking very strongly about ending a soul contract with somebody that I really don't plan on ever engaging with anymore. At one time I did, but there's just certain events that happen, some free will choice that came into play. And so that this no longer holds me back in any kind of relationship or the way that I feel about this person. I don't want to have any ill will. I'm going to end the soul contract. So that is a video that I am going to be making within the next couple days. I was hoping to get it done today. So hopefully I do. But some of you are in need of ending some contracts with some situations, maybe even not even maybe the contract is not with another soul, but it's your soul that has a contract with a certain lesson that you wanted to learn in this lifetime. And you're just like, you know, enough is enough. I don't want this anymore. I want to end this soul contract and maybe move into a different timeline to help you learn the other lessons that you're meant to learn or what have you. But a lot of you are in need of or in the process of nurturing the inner child. The inner child is wanting to come out and play is what I'm hearing. So get out and do things that are going to be playful and help you to feel more energetic, connection with things that are going to help you to laugh. So let's get some popsicle sticks and I'll read these I am affirmations and see if there's any healing that we are going to do today. If not, make sure that you, when I do the soul contract, the ending or I'm hearing binding even. So maybe some of you need to bind some soul contracts. I'm not even for sure what they mean by that, but let's see what they have. We got several that came out today. Crown chakra, spiritual connection and transformation connects you to the divine, angel, source, God, and your own divinity within. That's the crown chakra, guys. Heart chakra, I will love unconditionally. Center of compassion, love, empathy, and forgiveness. I am acceptance. A lot of you are in the process of accepting things as they truly are. You're moving out of this no energy. No, I don't want this anymore. No, it doesn't resonate with me anymore. No, there is something better. And into this yes energy of, I got to forgive so that I can be in alignment with this yes energy, so that I'm accepting of it, so that I feel as if I'm making the right decision. So letting go, guys, forgiving something, moving into this yes energy and moving into it with this forgiveness already had. Like, let go before you move into this yes energy fully. Or maybe this move, for some of you, not all of you, for some of you, very few of you, moving out of this no energy and into this yes energy is what creates the forgiveness. Okay, it helps you to move on, move past, realize there was something better all along. I don't have to hold on to anger, hurt, what have you. I am awakening to oneness. I can hear the language of the plant and tree beings. The universe speaks to me in multiple ways. I am the creator and the creator is me. Today, I will send gaze. I will receive upgrades to my DNA. I will get connected with the divine source, God, angels while send gazing. My consciousness will expand. Okay, guys. For whatever reason, I am not feeling like I'm supposed to be doing healing today. However, I feel like I'm supposed to explain to you guys about sun gazing. I wasn't expecting that. But so if you're not somebody that sun gazes, sun gazing helps with so many different things. It helps to absorb codes from the sun that will help your DNA to shift and change to a higher vibration, to a state of being more consciously aware or a higher consciousness, also to help you connect with angels, source, God, the energy of the universe, It also helps you to have spiritual sight. And this is just one of the many reasons why I love to do it. As soon as I sun gaze, I'll come inside and I'll be able to see into other realms and connect with other beings and things of that sort. Not always does that happen, but almost always. It is something that will definitely help you the more that you do it. So one of the things, if you're not somebody that does this, one of the things that you probably should do to start out is go ahead and close both of your eyes, hold your hand over one of the eyes, and the other eye that doesn't have the hand over it, just lightly open it to where it's barely open. Stare at the sun. It's going to burn. It's going to hurt a little bit. You may even feel it internally in your head kind of burning and hurting. Stay just a few seconds longer when you feel like you can't take it any longer, then close your eye. Don't open your eyes at all, but close your eye. And what is it that you see? For me already, I'm not even sun gazing right now, but just setting that intention to sun gaze. I'm seeing like a rainbow energy and also this like rectangular TV looking screen where there's something that's trying to show up. So some of you might see codes. You might see different geometrical shapes. You could see an angel. You could see different beings. Whatever it is that you see, connect with that before you start to sun gaze with the other eye. And then move over to the other eye. Do the same exact thing. Cover up one eye so that it's mostly black. And then barely open the other eye. Stare into the sun for the first several times that you do this. It could be, take you several days, several weeks to even work it up to where you can fully stare into the sun without your eyes being closed at all. You can fully open them. I can stare into the sun most of the time, just fully stare into it. I can see beyond it. I can connect with the energy of it and pull it into me. After I do this, you know, I'm not at that process of having to cover my eyes up. I've been gone from that for a couple years, few years now. But I do that and I see things instantly. It's almost instantly. So, I also just sometimes set intentions on connecting to 111, on connecting with the sun for upgrades to my DNA. So some of you might want to do that, but yeah, let's do the I am affirmations real quick. I am forgiveness. Today, I will forgive myself and others for the mistakes that we have made. So this goes right along with this side that's saying yes to adventure, to a new start in a relationship or a career or what have you. But there's something that still needs to be forgiven. Is this you or is this somebody else or both? Okay, so forgive. Again, some of you are moving out of this. No, it's not the right time. It's not the right person. It's not the right energy for me. Something is better. And into this new energy of yes. And that's what's going to help you to forgive. I felt like I needed to say that again. I am source energy. I will embrace my magical gifts. I am unconditional love. I am willingness, willing to change, willing to move forward, willing to say yes to this new adventure, willing to let go of and forgive aspects of myself and others so that I can feel like I'm making the right decision. I am unconditional love. I choose to see the world through God's eyes and not my own. Okay, guys, I hope that you got something out of this reading. Please like, share, subscribe, and follow. Let me know down in the comments below if this reading resonates with you. If you wouldn't mind liking this video and then putting either a name or a comment down in the comments along with the date, you'll be entered in to win a full reading giveaway at the beginning of the month for the month of May. Thank you to anybody who is already doing that. I do have quite a few names on there already. It is so much appreciated. Anybody who is making appointments, setting up times with me to get together for some clearing and healing of things, I so much appreciate it. I have been picking up a lot of business. I usually do around this time of year. So thank you to any of you who have been doing that or donating to my channel. It is greatly appreciated. If you're wanting to do any of that, the information is below on my website on how to reach me, as well my Gmail and any social media that you might not yet be connected with. I hope you guys have a wonderful day, guys. Much love to you. Bye.